Chris, you've voted in this before, not this year, but in past years. Do you think Kawhi deserved to be the MVP?
Look, I hate to disagree with Hubie Brown because I love Hubie Brown.
So do I.
But to me, it was a no-brainer. Mm. Now, was Kawhi the MVP of game six? No. But the MVP of the series? He led the Raptors in points, rebounding, and steals. He clearly was their best player. He went to the free throw line almost 11 times a game and shot more than 90% from the line. Mm-hmm. Like, he is the engine that got this team going. Even in his quote-unquote bad games, he was well over 20 points. 22 and 23 were his bad games. In the Oracle, in games 3 and 4, which really kind of ended the series, he averaged 33 points and shot like 51% from the floor. So to me, it's simple. And let's look at the other guys. Pascal Siakam certainly, you know, was really good last night, but disappeared in game 5, didn't even play the last 9 minutes, and had 2 12-point games. If we look at Kyle Lowry, who was sensational last night, especially early on, he scored 7 points in game 1, 10 points in game 4, 13 points in another game. So he didn't...
Game two,
okay. And then Serge and Fred VanVleet, neither of them averaged double figures in the series. Mm. So how in the world could one of those guys be the finals MVP? Again, Kawhi wasn't MVP of yesterday's game, but for the whole series, I don't think anybody else could have won it.
Mm.
No one else could have won it. And that's why I don't have a problem disagreeing with Hubie. I like Hubie too, but he dead wrong with this one. Mm. And so are you, Skip Bayless. Mm. How are you going to lead your team in points, rebounds, second in the assist? He's the de facto the best player on your team, the best defensive player on your team. He led the entire series in the 2019 NBA Finals. Kawhi Leonard led all players, whether you play with the Raptors or the Warriors, in fourth quarter scoring. Chris, you touched on it. Game 3 and 4, after they lost game 2, Nick Nurse huddled his team up in the locker room and said, guys, all we got to do is go back, get one game in Oracle, and we're back on serve. Kawhi Leonard stood up and said, F it. We're going to get both. B-O-F-F.
Mm.
Get both of them. And that, now, Chris, you know this. Had Kobe said something like that, had Michael said something like that, do you understand the lore that would have went with that? And then they go get both of those games and they win the NBA Finals?
That's a good point.
Mm. Yeah. Wait a second. Kobe and Michael had never quit on some previous team before they came to this.
Phoenix?
You remember that game when he went shoot? When he demanded a trade? Mm-hmm. You remember that, Skip Bayless?
Yeah, I do.
Okay, I thought you did. You remember everything,
yeah,
especially when it comes to Kawhi. But you seem to forget everything about Michael, about how he lost game 1 when Magic put that triple-double on him. Mm. But we've got talking about Kawhi and the finals MVP.
Mm.
If anyone else had a won it, man, Skip, that would have been the biggest ripoff since the Louisiana Purchase.
Really? That was a pretty big rip-off.
Yes.
I got to give you that one. We got him.
Oh, and next to Russia, when we swindled Alaska from Russia for $7 million, they thought it was wasteland. We've been pumping oil off Alaska ever since.
Although Manhattan Island was a pretty big rip-off too, right?
Yeah, a lot of rip-offs in American history.
So, here's my problem. I'm all about fourth quarters, and we just gave the MVP to a guy who is not the closer for the Toronto Raptors, because VanVleet was the closer, which is why Hubie said, I'm going to go with the closer. He closed again last night with 12 fourth quarter points, including 3 huge threes while Steph was going 0 for 4 from 3. And I thought Fred VanVleet did a sensationally underrated job of hounding and dogging Steph throughout the series, because They started starting him, like in second halves, they would just play him. He was playing high minutes, all of them on Steph. Yeah. And we just talked about Steph before you rejoined us here. And Fred's about 6 feet tall, maybe. I don't know if he's taller.
Probably about 6 feet.
Maybe.
Okay.
A little stockier than Steph.
He's stockier, but he was just all up in him. The whole series he was in him, just hounding him, just taking him out of what he did, fighting through picks.
Yes.
And it was a big deal what he did on defense.
No, it was huge.
Okay? And the driving force of the Raptors, the whole series, was Kyle Lowry, because he was getting in the lane at will. He was beating people off dribbles and just breaking down and destroying, picking to pieces Golden State's overrated defense, because there wasn't a lot going on there to me. But he was literally the driving force and came up so big. The turning point game was game three at Oracle, because it's 1-1. And he dominated that game with 23-9. And then he dominated the first half last night and set a tone that reverberated for them through the second half, because he scored 21 by halftime, 15 in the first quarter. So he deserves some. His value was at least equal to me to number two's value. Okay, over the whole series as the point guard, the driving force. Now we get to the fourth quarter. Well, Van Vliet closes because number two can't, because there are three big games where he just completely disappears down the stretch. I've never seen anything like it, but I saw it in San Antonio, and I kept telling him he doesn't have a fourth quarter backbone. It's not how he is made. And again, he had the one flurry in game five.
That was at the end of the game. It wasn't the last three minutes, but it was minutes five through three. That was huge.
And then you're up 6 points, and there's 3:28 left in the game. And what happened? Nothing happened. He disappears. He takes two shots, misses both of them. One of them an air ball, and they blow a 6-point lead at home to set up what was last night's
game.
Where was Van Vliet? Closing
in that game.
Okay, all right.
He didn't.
But I think they all turned to him because he'd just gone Jordan-esque and said, "You take us home," and he couldn't, and he didn't.
So you think it should have been Van Vliet?
Yeah, I'll go with Hubie. Yeah.
Van Vliet, when you say he's their closer, I think Kawhi is still their closer. If they have to go to somebody, they're going to Kawhi, as evidenced by the only Game 7 buzzer beater in NBA history against Philadelphia.
It was the luckiest shot in NBA history.
But they went to him, so he's the closer.
Okay, they went to him because he didn't – there was no other place to go on that play. He made that play on his own because he had to dribble by two guys.
But they put the ball in his hands and said, Chris. Go ahead, Shannon.
Hey, Chris, if you ask you this, why in the fourth quarter, if we saw it last night in the backcourt, they trapped Kawhi to get the ball out of his hand. Yep. If you remember game five, they trapped Kawhi to get the ball out of his hand. Why are they not trapping Van Vliet? If they're so afraid of him, why would they not trap him to get the ball out of his hand?
I'm glad you brought up the last play in game five, because if you're that guy that you're talking about, if you're the MVP of the finals, you just take on Klay Thompson and just drive him hard left and you just shoot the shot. Nobody can stop you from shooting that shot.
Michael Jordan passed up shots over a 6'2 John Stockton.
But there's not an obvious open guy. Just drive it and shoot it. It's your basic
Van Vliet
game.
Van Vliet, we're talking about the closer. Van Vliet's the guy that Kawhi passed
it to. I think he was shocked that he
got the pass. He could have had a look. He could have shot that. He didn't. Okay. He gave it to Lowry.
Okay, the play was actually being run in a baseline screen by Gasol to get Lowry free in the corner, right?
But Van Vliet, there was talk of why didn't he take that shot.
Okay, I'll buy that. Right? I will give you that.
I just, look, and Van Vliet played tremendously. And you brought up a good point about his defense, because I'm sure that went into Hubie Brown's thinking too. He helped shut down Steph. But you know the difference between being the superstar that everybody is counting on and being a guy that whatever I give him is gravy. That's huge. Like, they're not looking to Van Vliet to carry him in the fourth. I give him credit. He hit some huge shots. He's got guts and he's got skill. But it's different when nobody expects it.
You know what Skip Bayless doing? Skip Bayless wants to give the server more credit than the cook. Mm. I understand that you brought me my meal in a timely manner, but you ain't prepared nothing in the back.
Mm. Van Vliet just brings it out. Why was the cook sixth in plus minus? Because the cook was sixth on his team in finals plus minus. You like that? I love that.
Fred Van Vliet. I don't really like plus minus because Fred Van Vliet played unbelievable and he was minus 10 last night. Okay. You like that?
All right.
That's a good one.
But look at his fourth quarter. I don't know if you can flip to his fourth quarter plus minus because it's not going to be minus 10.
His fourth quarter was six.
I don't know. It was last night. Plus six.
Okay.
And they all, Kawhi's was plus four.
Okay. And help me out on this, Mr. Sharpe. What happened in a pretty pivotal game two down the stretch in Toronto? Klay Thompson pulls his hamstring and he is gone. And all of a sudden, Steph Curry just goes into his shell and can't even get a shot up. He goes 0-0. And what did number two do down the stretch of a home game? Did he come up big?
He was waiting. He was waiting on Fred Van Fleet. He was on the clothes of the clothes.
Oh, really? I think it was quite the opposite of that. I think Van Fleet's saying, are you going to do it or not? Because he winds up scoring 6 points on two controversial plays. He gets away with an offensive foul where he just elbows Draymond.
No, that's all part of the NBA.
No, I don't. I would have called that.
Hold on.
Michael.
I'm calling that foul.
Chris,
this was an elbow to the
chest.
Hold on.
What did Michael Jordan do to Byron Russell?
Right.
Okay, it was a...
Byron Russell still stuck.
It was a subtle push with an open hand.
Subtle.
This is a forearm to the chest. It was a subtle push.
Skip.
No, come on.
I don't think Michael Jordan could stand up to Skip Bayless' standards in 2019.
Hey,
that would be an interesting discussion.
And then how did he get his last two free throws? He drives it, and DeMarcus just picks his pocket clean, and the last two-minute report says, we blew that call. And he gets to go to the free throw line and make two more free throws. And that's all the points he scored down the stretch, and they lost.
It's baffling to me how anybody could think anyone other than Kawhi.
You know what's baffling to me is that nobody holds this guy accountable for disappearing in three of the six fourth quarters. Nobody. I do.
Even if that were true, and I don't think that's true, but even if he just carried them for 3.5 quarters and someone else closed, that still is huge. Hmm. I mean, somebody's got to do that. Hmm.